In 2019, more than 10,000 people were displaced by floods resulting from the rising Lake Albert water levels in Toroko District. The disrupted families have since asked the government to resettle them to safer places. Some of the most submerged villages include Kamuga, Rangara, Kanara, Toroko West, Kachwakumu, Kataga, Katolingo, and Mulaga. Earlier this week, officials from the Uganda National Meteorological Authority warned of heavy rains, floods, and potential disaster risks. Those in high-risk areas have been advised to prepare for any planned relocations. Now, leaders in Toroko have reiterated their demands to relocate residents in disaster-prone areas to Semiliki Game Reserve.
As in Toroko District, we face so many challenges. Whereby the whole sub-county of Kanara was submerged with water, and a whole ward of Kanara Town Council was also submerged. In this incident, all people are staying in camps, and we have been in a prolonged drought. Again, we expect floods to happen. But we as the district leaders, we have managed to come up with a contingency plan that will help us to solve some of the challenges, whereby we are going to launch it next month in April, around 15th. We are coordinating with the State for Disaster, Mr. Hira Lone. Today the chairman has submitted all the papers so that it should be approved and we launch it officially in the Toroko District.
The National Risk and Vulnerability Atlas puts Toroko District among the most prone to all natural calamities, including floods, earthquakes, landslides, hailstorms, windstorms, drought, and lightning. Previously, the district had requested at least 8 square miles of Semiliki Game Reserve be given to affected families, with 3 square miles of the 8 square miles being used to build a hospital and schools, while the 5 square miles being allocated to cattle keepers who have since lost their land to graze their animals.
The office of the Minister for Tourism to at least give us some portion of land, 5 acres, on our game, Rwenzori Wildlife Reserve game here, so that we can reallocate these people who are staying in camps. Another way of establishing these people, we are suggesting at least to look for some land elsewhere, whereby the Prime Minister Robin Anabaja pledged 500 million to relocate these people, and it is in pipeline. In the contingency plan we are planning, if we get this money, we'll make sure that we relocate these people.
In October of 2021, the Prime Minister Robin Anabaja visited Toroko District to ascertain the magnitude of the damage caused by floods and pledged to secure funds under the Disaster and Preparedness Ministry to purchase land to resettle the affected communities. While presiding over the belated International Women's Day on April 2, 2022 in Kawarole District, Nabanja revealed that her office had allocated 500 million shillings to Toroko District to purchase land for the relocation of flood victims. She accused Toroko District officials of failing to find land to host the flood victims. However, some leaders denied knowledge of the said funds. Wilfred Sekanabo, the district disaster focal person, says efforts by the government to resettle the affected persons have taken a long time.
The office of the Prime Minister, there was a proposal that we resettle the people who were affected by floods. This program has really delayed. However, I know government is taking some steps, but resettling people would be the most optimal decision that we should put forward. Because the people who are really affected, we don't expect them that the water will go back within 1 or 2 years. This water has raised above 2, 3, 4 meters at some levels. So subsidizing to the ground level is likely to take some good years.
Toroko District leadership wants the central government to degazette at least 8 square miles of Toro Semiliki Game Reserve land to host 11,000 people who are displaced by the floods. Jonathan Singwire for the news.